All right, today I'm going to be dealing with a little bit of the small and petty. I have to make the explanation a clarity of just how vast, how fast, how vast and how fast. Yes, it happens quickly. In the knowledge, I'm finding 15 kings of France that I am directly descended from. 15 kings in a row. So it's quite incredible knowledge. And then yet also even more incredible, let's not forget, are the 15 in sync at the same time, in the exact same moment of history, of Hungary, all the way back to Zoltan, his name is, and back to further Arpad, his father, to be the Arpad dynasty. Now, to be direct descendants from both sides of these strong power forces, we are talking 500 years of a pretty much just an absolute embrace of ownership over it all. Now, this was not in the Vaux name. This was not specifically in the Vaux name, which is very, very important that I have to reiterate. This is not in the Vaux kingdom's name. These particular reigns. Likewise, also during that time, we were there as Vladimir the Great, who led the crusade change from paganism into Russia of Kiev. A very important hero of the people. Many homages of through time. Particularly to his statue. So we have the mixture, when I start mixing in the Vaux, I don't want to mix the Vaux in right now, I just really wanted to talk about the kings. However, many years say, but I'm from these same lines, I'm from these kings also. So what is so great about you? Well, then I have to get gritty, then we start getting into the stones. Where are your stones with the names on of you right now of this day and age? Where are those castles? We get gritty. You're not just a king. You have to be a king of the 15 with the stones as well in surname form. So, because my mother has the stones in surname form all the way back to the Valley of Moses, the Valley of Moses Castle. Now, the Valley of Moses Castle is a ruin. Now, this is in Jordan. All the way to Jordan. I just found this out recently. A man Baldwin there from the first, Baldwin the first from Jerusalem. Right there. There's an obvious now attack. Go everyone and fix that castle, repair it, because people may be dying there, making their what do you call it? Their religious journeys. It's a very dangerous castle. It's one of the most dangerous in the world. People are dying there, and they're stupid. So I'm already saying, hello, it's your deal. You walk to the Valley of Moses Castle, you go there, you trip, you fall, you break your neck. That is your deal. So it's not anything on the Vaux at any particular time at all. It's not our fault. It's your fault. So that comes already with the terms and conditions. That we are not responsible. We are not responsible for anyone at any of the Vaux castles, any of the castles held by the Vaux kingdom at all. If you go there and you traipse and you fall and you hurt yourself in danger, you fall down the stairs, you break your neck, you twist your knee, your ankle, you are not coming out to me ever. That was your own doing. So that stipulation has to be placed. So, sorry, if you have the 15 king line and you thought you were a god from it, yes, you are. You are part of me, yes, as a lesser, though. You are a lesser. You, in this particular circumstance, we are political, and we have to claim as much land and properties of the world as possible. And right now, my name is one of the most powerful names in history. And if I say one of, I'm starting to think, well, maybe it is the only. It is that powerful. I'm already looking at the sad wimp the sad wimp of William, Prince William over there. Yes, we know, he is only living in the shared castle name, what is it called, Windsor over here, or this other one, and does he have absolute dominion of a name castle where he lives? Does he actually have that status? Does he have the status of, or is he only merely dealing with the share of lesser? And when I say lesser, there's a lot of terminologies of lesser. It could be lesser in your line, much further up the line, like maybe 20 generations ago or something. Is he living in these 20 generations ago castles and claiming them as his? Or is he truly living in his own castle that is his mother's maiden name or his father's name? You know, we have interspersed somewhere along the line, but I'd not think very much. It could be there is a Bingham association from Idaho, Bingham in my line that intermixes with his, because the Bingham is the Buckingham for short. So it could very well be a Buckingham Palace group that is mixed in with his line as the Bingham. So he could have Buckingham Palace there. But if he goes with that association, he also has to embrace me also as part of his family. So there we are, Buckingham Bingham. Now, so yeah, I'm sorry to tell Miss Vaux out there, Mr. Vaux, who think you are so great and you have Castle France. Right now I'm dealing with castles and kingships. How many kings do you have? How many castles do you have in your surname as close to you as possible? And I mean as close to you as possible. I mean this generation, your mother's generation, your you know, go up to your great great greats if you want, but my gosh, we are keeping our kingdoms here. We are not switching off to this bureaucracy of these past 100 years, of this intense socialism that has done nothing at all for the people, aside from turn them into just work zombies in jobs that they're not necessarily in an enjoy with. So now we have all of these castles that are falling into repair, disrepair, and all of this. And yeah, I don't want everybody running after me saying, now pay for it. So I've already made the mention of the way I'm in this paying for it, and that is going through the casino business. We're setting up this casino. I would like to have a northern casino also. I don't want to just have the one of the south. I am going with the design on that casino with the bubbles on top of the walls on the outer extreme, similar to a Carcassonne, but with the bubbles. The bubbles are reminiscent of the Russia, of the Kievan style, of also of the Hungary. In Hungary, they use the beautiful blumps, and they're these little fat things. They are kind of kindish, I know, but they can be quite beautiful, elegant, and they're also very Middle Eastern. So I'm going with that look. Now I also need to go with the disclaimer to all of you Middle East who are excessively like, oh my gosh, her family led the Crusades. Yes, they led the Crusades many times over, and they named castles. You know, they were the Crusadian castles in the Middle East, part of that group. So it does not mean come after me now as some kind of an expellent that you have to expel. That is just merely history. That is history. I'm not living on this, I'm the Crusadians now type of person. So let's make that clarification, that even though that is my castle, that is my family's castle, that no, I am not the association of that religion in this now time frame. It is historical. It is merely historical. Yeah, I know it is, and it is cute. And so now I'm also dealing with new builds. And yeah, somebody told me they'll only say one topic in the video. Well, she got it. And anyway, so now I'm only going on to now the builds of the houses. I want the houses in that particular region in the south, there near the Bois de Provence. I want specific area set aside for, I don't want to go say cob houses and all of this necessarily straight. It has to be cob or has to be some kind of a, there is the Cahill. His name is Cahill Gibrard, I think. It is a design of their soil. It's a soil stacking process that makes the beehive houses, and those are quite interesting, beehive in intonation with the Mormons, but yes, that particular style is very very indigenous to the earth without being a destructant. And there are not trees there, so it is not really the right of the people of those areas to even want and request the trees to make their building. They don't have the tree sources, so why would they be requesting the trees from out for their buildings? They can only really, in full rights, demand houses to be built from the soils, because there really are not available trees. So we have to look at soil builds very, very intensely. We're looking at the ram construction specifically for the I know, it can get really modern looking. I know it's a hard wall, and I believe ram construction itself is allowed on the crate, but I think they have presses now. I think they have a new press construction technique that they've created that is not so loud and hammerous. So if you go with this particular design of the ram with the press pressing down to make the particular stone walls, it's beautiful, and they do last 500 years. So we really need to take this particular construction mechanism, if it's available easily, and those will be helpful. Yeah, they can be harsh though. They can be very harsh, and they don't have the round. And so I'm like, well, let's design the round, make the round press. Let's make the round curved presses, so you can have the rounded corners of some of these buildings. Now I'm not going through, let's build a house for everybody brand new, We're not doing that either. But in there is able space, for smaller, and people really do like to have one house. I did see a design. It is there are only 9,000. It was a bubble house, and they can be silly. They can be absolutely silly. These little bubble houses, some type of place in California is making them. They can be absolutely ridiculously small, but yet authentically just unique and beautiful all at once. So I kind of think that type of direction is not a bad way to go for people. Because it's not always about, you know, spending every drip and drop of money in association of your life for a house. It's more like, let's just get in a house that's respectable to the space I need and require and live in it. You know, rather than spending an entire life, you know, just going for something that you may never, ever, ever be able to pay for. It's just like, well, I just, you know, pretty much am the renter of it, you know, paying again and again, you know. So, I don't know. Yeah, I prefer to put the people in the smaller houses over the grandiose American style. And I believe a lot of people, even when they retire, they already know this. They didn't need such a big place anyway. They already know. I did mention like the Fontaine Blue. I'm going to say it was the Fontaine Vaux. I believe the BL was an association attached to. So the Capetti. I'll call them the Capettis. I like to call them the Capettis. I think that is the cutest. The cafes, the entire dynasty is mine. Isn't that incredible? It is incredible. It is a rejoice moment. But yet there are many people that have it also. So let's not get like carried away. Many other persons have it. So when I am dealing here with ownerships here in France, and I'm looking at, well, I had the 15 king line, and my name is Berkeley, so I can take it also. I can take the kingdom over here. No, you can't, because you don't have the castles. That's the way it goes. So we're dealing with, you have to have the castles here in France in your name, or you're not included as part of this Vaux kingdom, as some kind of a major player here in France. Now that's where I'm going. So in the Mergent also. I don't really know much of the castles over there in the Budapesti land, but I imagine back to Arpad, they are there. All of the begins. Were with that group also, and so that's an interesting group because they are the Cumans. They are the Cuman witches. So yeah, so I descend also from the Cuman witches. So watch out. I love to be descended from the Cuman witches. That's a really funny one. So we have lesser in our family. And so I'm sitting here thinking, well, the Fontaine name is kind of lesser with me because it's just like a great grandfather somewhere out there, you know. But in reality, no. Because I find out that the king itself, several kings, lived there and died there. They were born there in the Fontaine castle. And so this is like a whoa. This is a very strange whoa for me because this is my mother and then this is my father. Line, their lines mixing in and having little bambinos all over again. So it's kind of bizarre because they didn't have bambinos back then. I don't believe they mixed. I don't believe the Fontaines mixed and had the children back then. But I can't be for certain yet. I have not found that out in truth. But that castle is linked, and that's so that family line is inextricably linked quite closely to being a very valuable player in politics today with the Vaux. I'm looking deeper into the berries. Now the berries, also the way a lot of it is done with like, you are of this canton region, you know, Vaucluse. This is the Vaux, the Vaucluse. So you take this, here's another clue, isn't it? Yeah, you take that region, and so I'm like, well, in retrospect, and then there's the berries, and then so there is the berry region. So my name is the berry region, and my name is the Vaux region there. And so I have several regions, see? So I start gathering as many regions as possible. Now I'm looking now at Prince William. Has he done this? Does he have this type of collection? I'm not seeing it really. I'm not seeing it over here in France. I'm seeing his collection being quite small, actually. So we have quite a massive fortune of France, and so this is my kingdom here, and this is my location. Is all of these particulars. And when I'm dealing with you guys out there going, oh my gosh, well, okay, I guess so, let her take France. You start to believe, huh? You start to believe after a while that, well, no, I don't have that, I'm just a Vaux. No, I don't have that castle kingdom line. I don't have the kingdom line of castles. No, of French kings, I don't have the French kings. So yeah, so I'm sorry to say, but you're still part. But I'm classing you as a lesser. So if you have only the canton zones, then you are still going to be higher. You're going to be higher than those who have the castles. Like if they have only the castles, like there's the Fontaines and they only have castles and they've never been kings, but you have the canton names, then you are essentially still higher than the ones who have the castle names. So we have to keep this up. But yet, overall, the highest is the kings. If you have been the kings of the cantons, thusly then even the owners of the castles they're under, then you rule all. You are the ruler then. So these are my people. These are my people that are the rulers right now of Europe. are the ones that are the kings, the ones who are the owners of the cantons, and the ones who are the also named after surname direct of the castles. So, excuse me. So, you are lesser if you are only one of those. You are lesser if you are only two of those. And so, if you are three of those, you are higher. Absolutely higher. I just have to make that explanation. Because it is a gritty business when you get out here and go, wave my flag, I'm this one. And big deal after a while. There's millions, right? There's millions who may be coming or stemming from that line. You start thinking, and no, it's not millions. They mixed, They mixed. It's not millions. We already know that they did have their particular group, and they had their... That's the way it goes. Anyway, I wish in a way that my grandfather was able to know that he was the keeper there of the Valley of Moses. That would be something incredible for him, because he was such a religious zealot. That would have been a highlight for him to have extra